All right.
You did it.
You made it here. You didn't fall down.
It was
Do you feel strong?
It was
tricky.
And it was
dangerous, but here we are.
Well, now you know where the fuck you are.
So glad we made it. Time will never change it.
So now... Oh, this is the first time you've ever actually fought these guys, huh?
Oh, no, they can't. I got invaded and died last time.
Oh, yeah, it's true. They're pretty tough, honestly. But not for you now. Not anymore. So now you can just... Jesus Christ. Yeah, that's a high damage number. So in the early game, these guys are the fucking farm spot.
Oh, yeah. I can see.
Because they give quite a bit.
Am I getting invaded?
Maybe.
I wonder. I got a humanity.
So the easiest thing for you to do is that once you get through the Alvina Cove, is to just make a straight shot to the door, really. Oh, boy. That was... Oh.
I mean, you can just stand there if you want, but...
I guess that's what he wants. I guess that's...
How many are there?
There's that guy.
There's a bunch.
You're nearly done, honestly.
What do you want? Like, are you even able to see me, dude?
Alright. They hang out in this forest all day.
You got... Honestly, it's for a good cause. It's for a good cause.
It's actually for, like, an objectively horrible cause.
Well, Alvina's cause is... I mean...
Oh, I thought you meant, like, cause. Why they were dying.
Oh, wasn't it over this way?
Nope.
Oh. Am I thinking of the other side of the forest?
Maybe. But where you want to go is literally straightforward.
Okay. I seem to remember.
And I think your memory of the DLC is fucking with you.
No. I just remember running along the edge of the cliffside to get to the little duck where Sif is hanging out.
Yeah. So that is straight ahead.
All right. Well.
Yeah, that's because you started on this side.
Yeah. Mushroom people.
Mushroom people.
Mushroom men.
I got a mushroom man for you
right here.
Yeah,
so at the end of the day, they're kind of, you know...
It's my penis.
They're hanging out and they're doing stuff in the name of Artorias, and that's a good...
I don't know if the mushroom people are.
That's a good name to do stuff in the...
Because I find it odd that Elizabeth can talk and these mushroom people don't seem to feel any reason to or can't.
Yeah, well, they're just like, yo, we're growing, and we're fungus.
I'm rolling in shit out here.
Yeah.
This is what I do.
Not much else to say about those guys. Okay.
Oops. So this is to kill the four kings.
Yeah.
A little bit of a sequence break.
Poochie woof woof.
Hey, I'm Poochie woof woof. Welcome to Jackhead.
Can I just scratch? Can I just scratch under your fur?
This is called the sword fight in your teeth.
Can I give you a little shooka shooka? You know a little shooka shooka? Where you put your hand right underneath the jowls right there?
Yep.
And you just give it the little shooka shooka?
So Kieran clearly moved his tiny baby shit shrine over to this much bigger, nicer one.
Well, this is a fucking battlefield in a...
Oh, yeah, isn't it?
Oh, man, look at that thing. Look at that thing. This is the grave, then.
Oh, yeah. Hey, it's Poochie Woof Woof.
But we all know that his body's not there.
Yeah.
Oh, and you reach out too. They actually let you reach out. Oh, I was expecting it to be all Sif-sided.
Right.
Because you're the player character, but you show emotion whether you want to or not. Get away from the grave. But Poochie, I gotta be here. But I need you to go.
No, says Poochie.
God damn it, Poochie, woof woof. I just want to give you a shooka shooka.
So it really alters the context. Like, in the original cutscene, Sif... Like, it's like, you get the fuck out, and like grabs that sword and like whips it around like a fucking baller. And here, Sif is just like,
damn it,
man. Come on, you know, like,
yeah, you know the deal. Why are you doing this?
I think you, I think way a million years ago, back when you were like unsold on the, because you didn't see enough of Dark Souls to see that it had a decent art style.
Yeah,
this was the one thing that you did saw that you went, that's probably the coolest thing I've ever seen.
ever. Yeah, no, conceptually, this is like, yeah. Like, you know, this is one of those things where it's like, I've seen this coming for some time now, so I've known
for
about
years.
It.
For years!
But...
Well, it's one of the most popular images for the game.
It's the same reason why Amaterasu is super cool, you know? Not much else you can say about it, besides, holy
fuck. She's good at it. So when you get to about 90%, you're going to want to back it off. You can easily block anything she's got going on at this point.
Fuck.
Dude, it's the worst. No.
They didn't have
to. And it's in this game, it's this one boss fight that's like really, even before the DLC came out, it's like, this is not a bad person, creature, monster. Right? This is a good person, hero, whatever, doing their job, but they gotta go because they gotta go. Right?
Well, for, you know, questionable reasons, but God damn it. Like, they didn't have to put that animation.
There's something at the back of his grave.
Hold on. Let me read the soul of Sif. He or she or it. Whatever.
Oh, Sif's a lady, lady dog.
Well, we don't know. I mean, but the goddess Sif is a goddess.
No,
so.
I mean, I'm pretty sure that Sif is, like, specifically referred to as, like, a girl dog. In her,
not
in
because her... of the namesake?
Well, also, there's no fucking giant wolf dong flapping around.
Well, yeah, but that just might be artistic license for not animating a giant wolf dong.
No, come on, man. So, I paid for this game.
Soul of Sif, the great gray wolf who guards the grave of Artorias the Abysswalker. Special beings of special souls. Use the soul of Sif, who inherited the Divine Night Sword to acquire a huge amount of souls or create a unique weapon.
So there's a lot of weird stuff going on with that.
Do you create the Artorias' sword with this?
So with Artorias' old soul, you could have created like the Abyss variant of the soul of the sword.
Okay.
With this, you can create... it's a cursed version, the real version, or the shield that protected Sif.
Oh, which I picked up.
Yeah. No, like the good version. Like
I picked up the shit version?
You picked up the shit version because all of its power had been used protecting Sif.
And that's what it smelled.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, boy.
So there's a lot of weird stuff, and probably the number one thing is that though the design is identical to Artorias' sword and it says that Sif inherited it, it's clearly a sword that was made for Sif. Because Artorias is not that big.
It's kind of nuts, though, how, like... The Sif ends up with the sword and shield.
Yeah. Hornet ring.
What's a hornet ring? Criticals go up. One of the special rings granted to the Four Knights of Gwyn. The hornet ring belonged to Lord Blades. Lord Blades Sirion. Yeah. Was it Sirion?
I think it's Kieran, but whatever.
Kieran. Okay. By boosting crits, the swearer can annihilate foes as Sirion's daggers. Laid waste Lord Gwyn's enemies. Possibly as an assassin, is what I'm hearing.
Probably.
Okay, so this just straight up boost crit.
Yep.
That's a cool ring.
Not as good as the fucking Leo ring. Lion ring, whatever the fuck it's called.
And then...
Congrats, you're an asshole.
Look at the picture on this ring, too. Like, He loved wolves, man.
Bark.
Look at him. He was the dog. He was. He barked like my dog.
So, Artorias loved wolves. Follow me on this. Artorias was so into wolf stuff that when you gain the blood of the wolf,
of the dragon of the shadow of the blood,
you fight like Artorias, which is backwards. That's how into wolves he was.
Man.
Is Artorias the first furry in Dark Souls? You don't know if there's a suit underneath that armor?
No one's gonna challenge it. We'll leave it at that.
Fuck. I didn't...
Why are you such a dick, bro?
You know...
Why are you such a dick?
Dude, I fully was like, when you're like, okay, now back off. And I was like, okay, here comes the big AoE. Here comes the big kill.
It's the complete opposite.
Here comes the big... Oh... He did do the big final attack.
Yeah, and there's one where...
And it's on your heart.
If Sif tries to do the double spin, she'll fall over.
Oh, no! God!
And like, struggle to get up.
That fucking... Ooh, that's a bad...
I remember back when the game first came out, there was a lot of theory crafting and a lot of, like, old style, like, trying to find the secret cheat of, like, is there a way to walk out of this fucking fight once you get to that point and spare Sif? Like an Eris, like, bring Eris back from the fucking dead kind of nonsense.
Yeah. That's a bad one.
All right, we cleared up all our loose ends. Now all we got is,
Forward
on the demon ruins and or, the fucking,
Giant Con,
that's correct.
I would leave Giant Con till last.
That's what I was planning to do.
Because it sucks.
Also, simply because I'm curious to get to this
bed of chaos that you keep hearing about.
To this mattress of calamity.
Mattress of calamity. Caught of entropy.
Hey, you think it'd be fun if I went like pyro for like proper pyro for a bit?
What do you mean?
Do I have enough spells to throw around?
No, I don't. No, in order to do that, you have to have a bunch of attunement.
Yeah, you'd have to attune enough to throw. Okay, well, there you go.
That was the attempt.
Yeah, I thought it would have been fun to go throwing fireballs around. I'm doing it occasionally. I could do more. Like at the beginning, I was like, hey, I might want to be a pyromancer. I've never done that. But I've also never been a guy with a spear. So, you know, that's new to me, too. But oh well, I don't want to have to reattune my shit to do this, so. Oh well.
Onwards. Oh man.
Downward.
You had a weird fucking trip in and out of this place.
Indeedly do.
It's probably the area you bounced off of the most times.
And I'm still super mad at that stupid fucking, stupid item.
Oh, yeah?
I'm super bad at it.
It's like just a generic soul.
And it's dude, like, it's just, it's upsetting that they would do that to me.
Why don't you go get it now? Why don't you just go get it now?
You saw the two cleanest jumps ever.
Why don't you just go and get it now, and then you'll have it, right? And
the
you'll be really satisfied.
Cleanest jumps I've ever made. We're not clean enough.
You'll be very, very satisfied.
Go fuck yourself. Alright, so what was around this corner?
Nothing much.
Yeah, no, it's not. No Casper mattresses yet around this corner?
Not quite.
Okay. Hey, you know, you're not so fearsome without your dogs.
Oh god, not even, like... Oh yeah, good job, Capra. You fucking did it.
To be fair, the unexpected ambush is a big part of his
sword is a phenomenal sword.
So you know what I thought running up to this? Because this is what's been trained into my brain.
Yeah.
Breath of the Wild, run up to here, push this over.
Oh my god, I can totally, I can absolutely fucking see it.
A bunch of Bokoblins are gonna get it. Alright. Lava, lava, lava. Fire, fire, fire. Burn, burn, burn. Hot, hot, hot.
It's like you're going to hell.
Oh, does this get more elaborate?
It does.
How does a tree not just burn the fuck up?
Because it's an arch tree and its composition is actually closer to rock than wood.
It's a super amazing material.
Yep.
Okay, we got double capras. Is this what we're doing for
is
this level?
Is this what we're doing?
Is this what?
Yes.
Triple? Quadruple?
Yes.
Oh, boy.
They have been fully normalized into regular enemies.
But their placement is so mouse-dropped.
So, there's... Okay, this is probably that little shot you had there, where it was clipping through the wall and you were looking at two mouse-dropped Capra demons.
Yeah.
It becomes very, very clear in Tomb of the Giants, but particularly the Demon Ruins, that they straight up ran out of time to make the game.
Is this what's happening? Because it really doesn't feel like these are placed in a way that is doing anything for anybody.
Like, it becomes exceedingly clear.
Maybe.
You're starting to see the tiniest bit of it right now.
Because the difference between, like, the randoms I fought in Ulusile was there was a caster and two guys just kind of walking around like,
yeah.
You know,
they were placed and they were doing stuff, and these are, as you described, mouse dropped. Just look, and there's a third one. The first two patches of the game dramatically improved this area by what
I'd be worse.
By what I would consider a factor of 1,000.
Okay.
And that's the version I played through. And I will try and impart why it used to be so much worse when you get there, but, like, you would have to go and watch videos. Like, it's like that.
Jesus.
It's intangible kind of thing.
Okay.
So you're playing a better version. Oh, you got his machete, by the way, which is awesome. It's a really good strength weapon. And that two-hander thing you got, it's a moveset you can pick up.
I bet you I can block it now.
I bet you can. Because you're cool and strong. You got a good shield.
So otherwise I had to use his soul to make this, right?
No, he doesn't even drop a soul. Because he's not special.
Oh, yeah.
Right? The lesser Capra demons use these great swords in pairs. The blade is cast iron and hooked. The sword's imbued with no particular magic. But for those who have the strength, its great weight will smash foes mercilessly.
So if you use two in each hand, you get to special...
No.
Oh. No. It's not a pair weapon.
Because you're not a... That doesn't even exist in this game. Because you're not a Capra demon. Only Capra demons get the cool moveset.
But do I get that baseball swing?
Yeah, but you only have one sword on it. Okay. You get a baseball swing. But
Alright, we got downstairs and we got over here.
You got a different downstairs.
And then we had that surface over there.
It's all down from here, man.
It is. And then we got fog doors. And then we've got there.
Yep.
What an open area. How honest.
Right.
How honest. And then there's something over there.
Yep. Your old pal from Demon Soul.
Okay. Let's see if I don't have to drop to that. Because I might have to drop to that.
You may have to. But if you had to drop to it, how would you get back?
That's the problem. So let's see where this stairway. So that puts me. You know what?
Hey, look, it's the worst enemy design in the whole game.
You know what? I don't want to know. I just don't want to know.
It's just a rock.
I just don't want to know. I won't ask. You don't have to tell.
It's a rock.
We leave it alone.
Hey, you got it.
We leave it alone. Okay. Looks like we can get to this path.
Indeed, you can.
Great. No drops required. And there's a second one. And come on.
I actually really like this build you're rocking right now.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm shocked that you have the ability to wear the armor. And, you know.
Oh, well. I didn't realize you were gonna do that to me.
Just a pro tip for you, Wolves.
Yeah.
These enemies literally live in a lava zone.
Oh, yeah. You're right. You're right. It's not gonna do a time.
Not only do they live in a lava zone, they live in a lava zone that is the birthplace of all pyromancy in the world.
This is true.
Your fireballs will have highly limited effect.
Why am I facing the other way? It's because I'm not locked on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's better to just stand there and take it. Well, that spear is making a fucking mockery of stuff that kicked my ass.
You're hiding a bonfire. Wow, okay.
Oh my fucking god. He hides a bonfire?
How about that?
Are you serious?
Wait, did you never kill him?
No.
You just walked past and ignored him?
I got the item and then I left.
You ran for it and then that was that?
Oh my fucking god.
Well, he hides a bonfire, apparently, in case you had a hard time getting through all those capras.
Game's fucking 8 years old.
Good job.
And I just found a new bonfire.
I'm glad. Glad to be of service.
Oh my god, I fucking love this series. I love this series so fucking much.
There you go.
Oh my god, I'm freaking out! I'm super upset! Oh my god!
Yeah.
Because of so many weapons just plink off him.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah,
and it's really annoying.
Yeah.
Fuck! God damn it!
Where was he in Demon Souls?
In the 2-2. In the mine. So this staircase is actually really bad for him.
Yeah, I can see it.
It was a very bad move on his part to run up to you.
He probably should have stayed down there and taunted at me.
Dude, why? Why, bro? Why?
He probably should have, like, scratched his balls.
Oh. Okay. I'm so... Oh.
Now, what do you actually do from the front? A command grab.
A really, really good command grab. Wow, your armor is fucking... Oh, wow.
Alright.
I like... In my own head, I'm like, he physically can't eat you because of your rock armor.
Around to the side. And then we stand. Or even behind, even. Oh no, he does get to do that.
Yeah, he's different.
Fair enough. That's a different moveset entirely.
Aren't you just better off, like, two-handing it and just going hard?
Whoa!
Time to leave.
Oh. Didn't see that one
so
coming.
It's not worth fighting. Except for that one, I guess.
Unless you do it quickly, like you said.
Yeah. Breaking weapon at incredibly high speed.
Ah, boy, how much is this gonna cost?
Not that much. But you do have to go back to Andre.
Yeah.
Because you're unable to repair your own weapons. That's their breaking point. It would be really funny if it was like, nope, your shit's broken. Get out of my face.
Alright, I don't think I can warp back to this one. I doubt it, so... Well, we'll find out, won't we?
Yes, we will. In a moment. Can't see, but I'm waving at the television everywhere.
Wave.
You fixed your stabby weapon.
You sure I couldn't do that just sitting on my own? Because I went over to him and I just paid him a couple bucks and...
I'm pretty sure you can't. Okay. I'm of course wrong. So yes.
It's possible, because it was just normal repair.
Well, the easiest way is that if we run into that the next time,
just
sit in a bonfire and try it.
But he's gone forever anyway.
I fucking hate these little guys, man. I hope you never see their attack.
You know what? I hope so too.
You're doing a pretty solid job of it so far.
I don't want to know.
I just don't want to know.
I don't even want to know. I don't know what you drop. I don't care what you drop.
Oh, hey, buddy.
Fuck everything about you.
Hey, what's up? I can just block your shit wholesale.
Wholesale.
Whoa!
Don't fling me off, though.
That's your trick, huh? Oh, it has a nice little lip. So that you can't quite get knocked off. Ah, you staggered him. What a bitch.
Well, it's right in the balls.
Right in the... Well...
He doesn't have any.
Demons reproduce via a very convoluted method.
Alright, we got up there. Straight ahead. We've got you, and then we've got over here. Okay. Well, just try not to fall.
And you also got fucking legs behind you over there. But he's pretty much a turret.
Throw yourself off?
Okay. Oh, if only. Just like your buddy, Ceaseless Discharge, huh?
He might throw himself off.
Aww. So, fucking, what's his name? The original Taurus Demon can also throw himself off. It's what, like, if you go back and look at, like, cool ways to beat the first real boss in Dark Souls. It's like, stand here and he can jump off.
Yeah. Well, I mean, some of the most amazing ones with the Dragon Rider.
Yeah.
Were just like, run up to him, stand on the left, he thrusts into the pit. Game over.
Yeah, enemy variety in this area takes a serious dip as well.
It certainly does.
This area has 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 5 enemies. You have seen 4 of them.
Man, I can feel it.
There's a 6th later, and it sucks. You can see why I didn't find that bonfire. You know what? Two-hand it, and it'll still do a ton of damage.
It'll still do a ton of damage. Is there another one coming down?
Probably.
Oh, god damn it.
Wow.
What about my armor?
Don't know.
Okay.
My armor! Get out of here, Aegis. Aegis, get out. Your other weapon was broken!
You son of a bitch. That chain is totally... a mimic.
What are you talking about? What?
Broken weapons, though.
Oh. Aha, you got punked.
Flame Ember.
Wait, what? They're different ones.
On the way back? I'm homewarding out of this shit. Fuck you.
So, Wolves, you're in a kind of a weird point of the rest of the game, in which, for your build, your character, your power level, there's gonna be very little that has any objective value.
Yeah, I get that. I get that.
I'm not saying don't explore. What I'm saying is prepare to be disappointed every single time that you do.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
All right, let's see if you can repair it.
Shabamzos.
Oh, fuck me.
Shabamzos.
I'm the Shabamzos today. You level up.
Do I even need to look over here? No, I don't.
Okay. Ah, how wonderful.
Well, that's good to know then, huh?
Oh, you do need to look over here.
Isn't that nice to know?
Isn't that nice? I'm thinking of DS2, probably.
Taught you about a bonfire, taught you how to repair your equipment.
Now, I'm the student.
You
and
did it.
You're the master at the Dark Souls.
I am the Dark Lord. Which, in any other context, is the edgelordiest cringe thing ever. But in this context, it's alright. It's pretty cool.
Pretty
it makes sense.
Edgelordy.
Contextually,
it's pretty fucking
has good explanations.
I'm the lord of the dark abyss that will swallow the world. Yeah.
We got that part.
I
can get a soul. I mean, I can get a level.
Why not? Get that endurance up to 40. Become giant.
Wait, oh shit, I overdid it really hard.
Did you?
I overdid it really hard.
Were you like...
I was right there.
No, you didn't. You didn't
overdo
it. Oh,
no, I didn't.
Pop one of the smaller ones and you're good to go. Or actually, pop the second biggest one.
I only have one type left.
I'm pretty sure you have a couple.
Minus Sif.
I'm pretty sure you have two. Yeah, pop the Brave Warrior one. That should do it. Yep. My soul magic is on point. Ooh, getting up to that endurance. Getting up there.
That magic number.
That 40 endurance. Become giant.
What do I do with Soul Sif? Stare at it?
Yeah, just look at it, I guess.
It's pretty. I picked up, where is it? It's not in keys.
Yes, it is. It's in keys. But you can't look at key items in here because you can't move key items out of your inventory.
Of course. No, I don't need any of that. That's fine.
All right, keys. You can get off, and you can tell me what I need to know. Weapon ascension. Large flame ember used in ancient rites, handled only by blacksmiths knowledgeable in ancient methods. And, so Andre can probably do this, though.
Nope.
Damn.
Skeleton.
Okay.
Skeleton handles flame and chaos. Rickert handles enchanted and magic. Andre handles regular occult and miracle. And the giant blacksmith handles boss weapons, crystal weapons, and lightning.
I've never used Rickert.
Nope. He's exceedingly good if you're running a magic build, because he'll let your weapons scale off your intelligence instead of your strength or dex, which is highly valuable.
Mystery enemy to the end of the playthrough.
What do they do? You'll never know. You'll never know.
They don't even have animation.
So there's that item, and then the door.
Yeah. They don't even have animation.
Who needs animations, man? They do have an animation.